And we start right now with the latest out of Aurora tonight, where police released the body camera video today showing officers shooting a 14-year-old armed robbery suspect.
And we're also learning more about what led up to this shooting. Investigators now say that the teen was armed with a pellet gun when he was shot. It started when officers spotted a group of teens in hoodies and masks who reportedly tried to hold up a vape shop near 8th and Dayton Street last Thursday. Jor'Dell Richardson ran away from officers, and this is what body camera shows happened next.
Get on the ground, I'm gonna tase you!
You can then see the officer throw a gun away. Aurora's interim police chief defended his officers at a news conference today, but also said the department is mourning Jor'Dell's death as well.
I want to once again extend my condolences to Jor'Dell's family, to his mother, his father, his brother, his little sister, his grandma, his extended family. No matter where this investigation takes us, no matter where we end, it is a tragedy because a young man has lost his life.
And we're also hearing from Jor'Dell's family, local leaders, and even police tactics experts tonight.
Yeah, let's go first to Fox 31's Greg Nieto for a look at how the family is reacting tonight. Greg.
Hey there, Jeremy. Yeah, you know, for the past 8 days, this strip mall here just off of 8th and Dayton has been a focal point for the Aurora Police Department. Tonight, the community says this city belongs to us, and we're going to take it back.
While Aurora police were holding a press conference about the events on June the 1st inside department headquarters, nearby on the steps of City Hall, friends, family, and supporters of Jor'Dell Richardson gathered to mourn and demand answers. The 14-year-old shot and killed after interaction with police a week ago in the aftermath of an alleged robbery attempt at 8th and Dayton. Body-worn camera footage showing the moments police confronted the teen. Detectives revealing that Richardson had been armed with a pellet gun.
Thank you for being here.
Among those speaking,
this is going to be a long road for us.
Jor'Dell's mother.
To know that the police didn't even try to think twice that he was a child and that he's human. People make mistakes. They didn't give him a chance to redeem himself.
And Jor'Dell's father.
He stayed happy, humble-hearted, loved to dance, loved to see everybody smile, silly, a character, a child. A child.
Both parents staying strong as long as they could. But even parents can only shoulder so much. Little sisters now with fewer chances to say goodbye to a big brother.
Our son is in heaven, and I know we will meet again.
Late tonight, I spoke with one of the family attorneys who tells me what might be next for the family is they are asking for the chief of police to apologize and resign. Breaking up on Fox 31.